Unfazed by the COVID-19 pandemic, a New Zealand-based conglomerate run by Filipinos called Smoke-Free Innotech is gearing up for an initial public offering. The company started out as a coffee business and has since expanded to manufacturing, franchising, property development, as well as tech solutions. For more on its planned IPO, we are joined by Smoke-Free Innotech's Chairman and CEO, Jets De Jesus Lacson. You seem to be involved in a lot of business. So right now, where do you get bulk of your revenues? And of course, since you're planning to do an IPO, where are you expecting to get your growth from or your revenues in the future?
Thank you for your questions. By the way, SFIO is a publicly listed company on the OTC market in the USA. And currently we have five strategic business divisions. And all of these businesses are currently in New Zealand and Australia. And basically we started with one of the companies where we started as a startup. That was in 2013, and we launched that startup in 2015, and it's called Epiphany Cafe. So we can talk more about that, Miss April, if you later on.
So when did you list in the over-the-counter market?
That was October 2020. And what we've done from then is we've restructured the ticker. So basically, we are in the process of finalizing the restructuring, including the renaming of the ticker, SFIO. And in the next few weeks, we will launch our fundraising campaign for our development projects in our conglomerate.
So it's like a backdoor listing, if that were the case. So with that, like, where are you going to use the proceeds? Like, how much are you planning to raise? And, you know, where are you planning to use the proceeds?
So basically, we are raising around 30 million. And that 30 million will be divided into three key aspects in our conglomerate. One is for the expansion of our pilot project in SFIO, which is Epiphany Cafe. And secondly, we are also aiming to invest or boost up our property development projects here in New Zealand. And third is we are also investing in each individual companies within the conglomerate for their internal growth.
Do you already know what the new name of the company will be, because it's a backdoor listing, or it's not yet ready at this point?
We have options currently, and we have submitted our options and have done our paperwork. But currently, we haven't finalized yet. But I guess that's one of the things that we will announce during the launch of our fundraising. And we're aiming to launch it in the next 2 to 4 weeks.
30 million, for what percentage of the conglomerate will investors have? Will the public own with the $30 million?
We've already done the pre-IPO per se, and a majority of the amount or significant amount already been raised. And we are completing the amount to be raised during the fundraising.
So those are all primary shares, I'm guessing, or will it be a mix of primary and secondary?
It will be a mix of primary and secondary shares, Ms. April.
Like, at what level of valuations, you know, the 30 million that you're targeting, what level of valuations will your shares be priced at?
Well, in terms of the, since we are already on the stock market, so we're not guaranteeing the value or the, especially for our investors and incoming investors. While we are not guaranteeing the value of share price, what we are ensuring is the performance of the businesses within the conglomerate. Mm-hmm. And at the moment, we are confidently in our performance, and collectively, because these are independent businesses and companies, and collectively, the financials are robust, and majority of the businesses or companies within the conglomerate are already in the business or in the industry for more than 20 years, and some of them even 25 years. And that can clearly demonstrate that the conglomerate has the stability and viability in the market.
Earlier on, I remember you were talking about how a big chunk of what you were planning to raise has already been committed. Can you share with us who these investors are? You know, are they Filipinos? Are they foreigners? Like, what are their backgrounds? You know,
actually, it's a mix, but majority, I would say, are Filipinos, And the reason being is we've targeted our kababayans, and their background is in retail and also in businesses. And they're going to be not only just investors, but also they will be involved in a few areas in our businesses.
You know, a lot of food companies have been affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. I'm just curious if you guys have also been negatively affected, and, you know, if that were the case, why do the fundraising now?
Everyone has been affected, and we're just very blessed that we are here in New Zealand. So the impact is very minimal compared to the other parts in the world, like Philippines or other countries. And the reason why we are doing the expansion now is because I think this, and we believe that this is the perfect timing to enter the market. Because essentially, a lot of businesses, if not all, have been impacted by the pandemic, and the market itself has been shaken. And a lot of people or a lot of businesses are adapting. Although the market landscape itself won't be an equal playing field, but then we see opportunities where we have a big chance, where everyone else as well is adapting to the changes.
So what opportunities do you see? I mean, which is why you're raising capital during this time of the pandemic.
One is we're leveraging on our collective efforts and alliance of companies within the conglomerate. So basically what we've created is like an ecosystem wherein we have producers. These are our food manufacturers within the conglomerate, and also the consumers. These are the franchisees and the businesses within the conglomerate. So essentially all of these companies working together as a collective business, one is to be able to have the stability within the group. And secondly is collective efforts to expand into the market. And what we've done during the pandemic is we've evolved and we've developed micro business models. So traditionally, our franchise model is similar to any other franchise businesses, wherein it's the traditional, you have a big site and you franchise that site. But for us, we've created licenses. So within, let's say, for example, for Epiphany, Epiphany has a number of capabilities. We call it capabilities, like offerings. So what we've done is we modulize those offerings and transform those into a system. And we offer that system as a license opportunity for others, wherein we can set up these licenses in existing stores. So if you have, for example, an existing store or cafe, a restaurant, you can have an Epiphany branded corner in your cafe as a licensee. So from there, you can have multiple licenses. So we've done a lot of things, and coupled with our technology and our know-how and the collective efforts of the companies within the conglomerate, we believe that we can provide opportunities not only for our investors, but most of all for our franchisees and the people and the consumers themselves.
Okay, with that, thank you very much, Jets, and good luck to your company.